try to be as loud as possible in both directions simultaneously. So thank you all for coming. I'm Christy Lockhart. I'm the assistant director here at the Thomas Green Public Library. And I'd like to welcome you to our fourth winter into spring concert at the Crane Series. We have one more concert, one more, planned for May the 1st with Gene Danton, who's going to be, who's a Broadway singer, which will be something a little different for you before we head out on the lawn for our outdoor summer concerts. We're going to be doing a concert in June, July, and August out on the lawn, and those will be Saturday concerts, so definitely keep your eyes peeled on our calendar. To see our full calendar of events, you can visit our website at thomascreenlibrary.org, or there are paper calendars sprinkled throughout this building for you to take home with you. I do want to say just a few thank yous as usual. Thank you to the Thomas Crane Public Library Foundation who purchased our beautiful piano, which you are going to enjoy today. Thank you to Richard Grunler for his expert help in keeping the piano in excellent condition and tune. And Richard was actually in yesterday tuning the piano, so we can thank him for its sound. And finally, thank you as always to the Friends of the Library who provide the financial support for this program, as they do so many of our programs. Without them, we wouldn't be here enjoying the wonderful music we're about to hear today. So without further ado, may I present to you the Essex Piano Trio.
Good afternoon. Am I still on to speak?
It is, yes.
Yeah, all right. Thank you. It's so good to be here. We were, I think this was our last concert that was scheduled for us, or it was the first of our concerts that got canceled during the pandemic. That's how we put it. We were going to come and play Beethoven for you, and we didn't. But we're back, and thank you for having us. And thank you also for that beautiful piano. It is a treat. It plays beautifully, and we're looking forward to that. So just a word or two about our program. You've got the program in your hands. We're doing all French music, and some very familiar composers and some not so. So the way the first half of the program works, we're starting with a very favorite, very familiar tune, The Swan, that we've arranged for trio. You'll know it, whether you think you do or not, you'll have heard it. And it's a beautiful solo for Dave. And we go to that, to our two women composers on the program, Chaminade is the second piece, a trio, the second movement of her trio. And it's so, so beautiful. And that's our feel-good piece for the day, Chaminade. And then we close the first half with Germaine Taillefer. And you may not have ever heard of her, but we think of her as the flapper girl. Right in the early 20s, and writing just a wonderful mesh of styles. She was friends with all the composers of that time. She loved Fauré and Poulenc and Satie and Ravel, and so they were all her friends. And so she wrote in their style sometimes, but uniquely herself. So we think, even though that's a little more challenging and probably the most modern sounding piece on the program, that you will enjoy the freshness of it and the beautiful sounds. So first The Swan, then the beautiful lyrical movement from Chaminade, and the four movements of Taillefer, and you won't clap between those, but you can clap every other time you like. So thank you.
Thank you.
and talk while you stand up? That be okay? Yeah, we'll just be very efficient about that thing. So, thank you. You're a great audience. What fun. And wasn't that a weird and wonderful piece? You know, it took her a long time to write it. She started in 1916, two world wars in the middle, and had gotten home to find the Nazis had destroyed a bunch of her scores because they had taken over her house in France. And so finally, in the 1970s, she got pretty much in her 80s to get a chance to finish it. So I'm so glad she did. It's a magnificent composer. So the second half of our program is pretty much structured like the first. We're going to start with a transcription of a very famous piece by Ravel, The Pavane for a Dead Princess, which you may have heard for solo piano or even orchestrated. The composer orchestrated said he didn't like it, but he did. But anyhow, we like it, and we like the transcription that we made of it. And then we're going to play an odd juxtaposition. Fauré, very famous art song composer, you know, may know him for that. Wrote a magnificent trio in the last year of his life. This is in the 1920s, right? Did I get it right? And so it's one of the more recent pieces on the program. He's trying a bunch of new styles. And we think this one fits in this building so beautifully. It just feels like cathedral-like. It's very transparent. It looks easy on the page, and we finally said, what? It's so complicated. There are all these little nuances, and it's just woven together like a tapestry. So we think you'll enjoy it. It's a very beautiful piece. And then we close with a piece that is written by a more modern composer, we think, but it's written when he was 17 years old. So we got the end of life Fauré and the bratty teenager version of Debussy. And it's a wonderful trio. It just sparkles. It sounds like Saint-Saëns. It sounds like Puccini. It sounds like everybody that he loved as a kid growing up. And so we hear all of that in his four-movement piece. So we start with Ravel, the Pavane, and then the Fauré movement, and then the four movements of Debussy, and then you're out of here. So, thank you so much for coming.
Thank you.
And you can sit back down.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you all very much for coming. I hope everybody gets home safely.
See you next time, hopefully.